Hey, good morning, good afternoon, evening, whenever you're watching this video. Today about learning, how do we learn? As you know, headline in the on the top of my portal, Dan Frolik, is Learn, Enjoy, Live, because I believe that learning new stuff makes us happy, at least it makes me happy, learning new skills and or knowledge and applying it sometimes, yeah, at least. And enjoying our life means really living, you know. So learn, enjoy, live. And I was intrigued the other day by this learning. So how do we learn? And of course, there are like hundreds of theories. I'm not expert on learning, but I was like searching on the internet and found a couple of really interesting resources. Today, let me share some of them with you, the ones which I found most interesting. I think the first one is my favorite Ayurvedic your guru, Dr. Svoboda, and maybe this is something which, you know, you would not expect about learning, but he is, you know, one of the most profound experts on Ayurveda and Indian philosophy in the Western world. And he says, and my wife attended some course with him, and he says that the most important for learning is to be in a good mood, which creates a receptive mode. So I'm not sure I'm quoting this 100% correctly. And he would encourage people to sing mantras, to get into this receptive mode. So try it for yourself, singing, one idea. Then of course people talk about neuroplasticity, also known as brain plasticity, and it's the ability of the brain to change throughout an individual's life. So every time you learn new skill or feel new emotions, so it doesn't have to be a skill, the brain changes and develops new connections between neurons. In simple words, more you train your brain, better your cognitive function becomes. So there's a link with more information about this, but this neuroplasticity seems to be existent throughout the whole life. So is sometimes people, you know, believe that it only works for kids, and kids can learn obviously much faster than us adults, but it doesn't mean that it stops when you become a teenager. Your brain can be neuroplastic apparently for the whole life, but it depends how you train it. Two things there, meditation. Apparently meditation, and a guy called Richard Davidson, he led some experiments in cooperation with Dalai Lama, and he found that meditation is rewiring and changing the brain and creating new connections between neurons. So I think that contributes to the neuroplasticity. And exercise. So according to multiple studies, and again, link to one of them is below the video, consistent aerobic exercise over a period of several months induces marked clinically significant improvements in executive function. In other words, cognitive control of behavior, and increases gray matter volume in multiple brain regions, particularly those that give rise to cognitive control. So that's very interesting. So exercise, you know, some of my other videos are about fitness, so you don't have to watch the videos of me, but I think the exercise and fitness, physical activity, is again important, you know, to developing your brain. Interesting discussion on a different aspect of learning is about these learning styles, you know, and there are a couple of them: visual, pictures and drawings, logical, reasoning system, verbal, words, both speech and writing, physical, using your body, hands, touch, you know, senses, and oral, auditory, musical. And then there is also social and solitary. So some people are better learning within the group and a workshop or course. Some people are better individually. So I think what is important here to find out what works for you and make sure that when you learn something new, that the way how it's taught, the way you learn, is respecting the whatever style you prefer most. It's not that people have just one learning style. I think it's always a bit of a combination. You know yourself, some people learn better when reading the text and then remembering it. Some people would freak out if they have to memorize a text. So if those people maybe are much better with the pictures, you know, some pictograms. So, you know, that's the way how you can find out for yourself which learning style works for you the best. Huh? There is also interesting element of learning which is talking about AGES, so attention, generation, emotion and spacing. Again, you can read more in the link below this video. I found the most important there, the spacing, so that you don't like learn one topic in a one big chunk of either information or time. You have to make breaks, you know, so learn a bit, then rest, let the brain process it, and then come back in 2 days maybe, come back to it again, and you know, reinforce the learning and learn something new on top, and then again make it. So this spacing means that you kind of spread your learning over a certain period of time and not just try to learn something new in one block. So I think that's it. And last but not least, there is this interesting topic about 10,000 rule, 10,000 hours rules. Apparently this is not true, and listen to a guy called Josh Kaufman, again video link is below here, where he is kind of deconstructing this 10,000 hours rule and I think giving a chance to every one of us to learn something without investing 10,000 hours, because I don't think, you know, we all have 10,000 hours always to invest into learning. And from my side, as the last element is, my wife always says, you keep forgetting things, you know, and I tell her, that's good. And I think there's now even some scientific evidence that forgetting is good, because forgetting information which is useless or became useless is actually creating space in the brain. And I was always convinced that's the case, somehow intuitively, but that's now even confirmed by science. Now, of course, if your wife tells you buy X and then you end up buying a new phone, I think that's not really working. You have to find your way how to remember buying X, you know, if you don't remember that by heart. But I think that's another topic about, you know, interpersonal relationships and and what to forget and what not to forget. That's it for today about learning. I hope you find it useful. Of course, there are other things. So if you came across in your experience about some interesting topic about learning, please write it down in the comments so that I can learn something new as well, and also the other readers can benefit. My name is Dan Forwards. I'm the author of danforwards.com, a portal with resources how to survive your life, and also xfit.com, an online fitness program for successful but busy people, where you can learn how to exercise on your own, anytime, anywhere. If you like this video, give me a like, find a way how to share it with your friends or colleagues, whoever you think might benefit. That's it for today. Have a great day.